My name is Christian von Koenigsegg. I'm 40 years old, and for half of my life, I've been on the quest to be a leader in the hypercar industry, utilizing Swedish design combined with visionary technical solutions. Our latest car, the Agera R, is built in the old hangars of a former Swedish fighter jet squadron. Their symbol, a ghost, is now proudly painted on the back of every Koenigsegg. So here we are at station 6 out of 7 on our production line, and I'm going to talk a little bit about our rear suspension on the car. If you want a car to go fast, and especially on the track and in cornering and braking, all of these aspects, it's not enough with a powerful engine. You also need a chassis and a suspension which is up to snuff to get the power to the ground, really. When I open this, you can see what we call the Triplex Suspension. First of all, it's very unique and it really enables our car to get maximum traction, maximum level of comfort. This is actually a road car as well, but with very little compromise between comfort and handling and stability. It's basically one extra shock absorber connecting the rear wheels together. They have one shock absorber each here going down into the chassis with the spring holding the car up. But then there's this extra shock absorber tying the wheels together. And underneath here you can see our quite unique Z-shaped anti-roll bar. So the reason why we developed this third damper connecting the sides together is that we were getting so much power in the car that we were getting more and more squat during takeoff, which in one way is good to get traction, but you don't want too much movement in the car so it's easy to handle and that it's stable, but you still want a lot of traction, of course. Most manufacturers solve this need by changing the geometry of the suspension so the car can't squat due to geometric restriction. The backside of doing that is that it dilutes the geometry that you need for cornering and the other parts of handling. In a way, it's an anti-squat damper. It means we can have a truer suspension geometry than otherwise. On top of that, it has other side effects, as it is a new dimension of dampening where you have forces going from one wheel to the other. So for example, if you're driving on a road which is a little bit uneven from left to right hand side, you have independent movement of the wheels, which is good. But then you have the anti-roll bar, which is there to stabilize in cornering, which you rather not even have while driving straight on a bumpy road, as it makes the car feel a little bit less comfortable than without it. But what's interesting is that this damper actually counteracts the forces of the anti-roll bar in that situation. So when this wheel moves up on a bump, and this is not hit by a bump, but you're still driving straight, this link here pushes the anti-roll bar this direction, pulls a similar link on this side that direction, and wants to lift this wheel up as well, which causes, on all cars with anti-roll bars, a certain amount of harshness. But when that is happening, when driving straight on road like that, this shock absorber actually sends a force to this side of the wheel, counteracting the force of the anti-roll bar, cancelling that energy out. So you get the same or similar type of comfort in a straight line as if you did not have an anti-roll bar, which is a great side effect. Also, the damping curves of this shock absorber are very, very special. Basically, it's focusing on low speed damping force. So when you get high speed, when you hit something harsh and fast, Basically, it's not doing much. It's more for the lower speed dampening where it's efficient. So there are a lot of different philosophies that can be applied and that we can enhance in the future. But the starting point is to reduce squat, increase comfort, and reduce roll by the fact that we can have a stiffer anti-roll bar than we otherwise could have without it. Now at the front of the car, we can see we have a similarly complex suspension layout. And actually here, everything is very, very low to have, again, as low center of gravity as possible. But also we needed to make it low to be able to get our roof into the car, which is a very unique feature. So we couldn't have anything in the way for the roof to slide it in here. But it had the side effect of actually also lowering the center of gravity. So that's a perfect example of two needs working together without compromise. Extreme upright technology, extreme brake technology, all of these systems combined made it possible for us to take the world record from 0 to 300 to 0 kilometers per hour. It's really all the systems working together. If one of the systems, like suspension or brakes or engine or gearbox, weren't up to the task, we could not make a record like that. So it's all systems working together, putting the power to the ground, creating stability, creating traction, and braking power.